Hey you, how's it going? My name is Ruby Price and welcome to A Week Ago. I've slept in for what I was supposed to do this morning, so that's why I've got the hat. Yeah, I could do the coffee. There we go. Just finished a guest spot on a F1 podcast. Getting that sweet, sweet marketing. The words escape me, it's too early in the morning. Right, so I'm off to the bank to see if they will upgrade me back to a student account. Yeah, I'm doing an adult thing to do a student thing, hopefully. I checked online with one of the, you know, online chat people, and they said that I should be able to do it. I'm just a bit doubtful because I've already had a student account before and it's now a graduate account, and really what I'm asking them to do is revert it. And I've got all like the evidence that I'm going to be starting uni soon and stuff like that. So yeah, other than that, I mean, Avengers Endgame came out today, so I might be coming home with that. Just maybe. I think we know what's going to happen. Yeah, let's go. My appointment's soon, so, you know, I do need to go. So, place your bets, place your bets. Did she get Avengers Endgame? Yes, she did. And she has no regrets. No regrets. Not even a letter. We're going to watch it tonight. Also, for the record, Boris Johnson is just a bit of a dick. We've got the lights off. Curtains are going to be closed. We've got candles on.
Really excited about that.
And we're all ready to watch Endgame. These two watched Infinity War yesterday in preparation for it. But you've never seen Endgame, have you, either of you?
Nope.
Nope. We'll be back with a review from their point of view when this is over.
Good, I enjoyed it. Yeah, I enjoyed it.
I cried again.
Well, no, I heard you.
So I did want to film a video today, but really, my nose has just been running all day, and I don't want to be filming a video but having to stop like every 15 seconds to, you know, blow my nose. So yeah, that cold is still sticking around. Couldn't it at least pay rent or something? I'm fortunate that I can hopefully get something done tomorrow. I'm not working tomorrow, so yeah, that doesn't mean there's going to be no video this week. That just means there might not be one. I've been compiling a list of video ideas that will be good to make. Who fancies a bit of bolognese soup? Because apparently I do. Genuinely never heard that song before in my life. We'll be right back. time for a bit of a change of tone. Something bassy. Content. I mean, the fact that I've showered is surprising enough. This week is very much one of those weeks. So last night, I might have just done a very, 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 very small home workout routine thing. I mean, it comprised of sit-ups, planking, more sit-ups, and squats. But that's more than I usually do. There are parts of my whole physique at the minute that I can make changes to, but they just require effort. It sort of ties into a video that I included on this list of videos that I'm probably gonna make in the future. So I won't go into it because then what would be the point of making a video? It's Wednesday. Whatever that means. So in a totally not, I only remember this because I just saw a scheduled tweet that I made, state of mind. Yeah, today I've been on hormone replacement therapy for 1,500 days. The thing that reminded me was I scheduled a tweet with a link to the 1,000 days on hormone replacement therapy video that I made. There hasn't really been as many or as easy enough to describe differences between 1,000 and 1,500 days. There have been, you know, changes since then. You would hope, yeah. For starters, my boobs are bigger. but I don't know if that's lifestyle or not. It's very strange, you know. 1,500 days on hormones is sort of a bit like, it's a number that doesn't really compute. Like, think of 1,500 days. What actually is that? 5 years would be 1,800-ish days. This is obviously 1,500. So it's not 5 years, but it's a long time, a long fucking time. I started hormones in May 2015 and, you know, it's now September 2019. That's a long time. I came out as trans for the second time, for those of you who are unaware, in December 2012. That was a very limited coming out, but that was still coming out. December 2012 to May 2015 was my journey to get to hormones. That's actually now shorter than the journey between getting hormones and today. How? How? I've actually been on hormones longer than I have not been in my trans life, I guess you could call it, you know, from actually coming out to now. Yeah. It's crazy, really crazy. It just, it's not something that I can sort of process, you know, hence why there isn't a video on it. There's, you know, just this, whatever the fuck this is. Yeah, but at the same time, it's also the kind of thing, you know, I wasn't really counting down to, hence why I completely forgot that today was it until Oliver Simkiss liked my tweet. It's also funny, today is the year since I posted my dilation video, which arguably is responsible for the last 12 months of my YouTube success, in relative terms, obviously. It's the video that pushed me across into 1,000 subscribers for sure. And now I'm on 1,715. What's special about September the 4th? You know, I won't be making a video, touch wood, when I reach 2,000 days on hormones. I probably won't be making one when I reach 3,000 days on hormones. 10,000 days is a different matter, but, you know, that's fucking massive. 10,000, fucking hell. I don't even know when that'll be. I don't even know if I'll still need to be on synthesized hormones after 10,000 days. That would be quite nice, actually. Scientists, work on that. But yeah, 1,500 days on hormones. Here's to another 1,500. I really could have filmed a video today, couldn't I? About something at least. So then, let's do the first of the last four shifts. I'll probably do it at the Dialworks. The countdown is on. Really, it's sort of just a big coincidence that this week I finish working at a place I've worked for since 2013, and next week I finish a series that I've been working on for a year. Apparently there's just something about September. The dishwasher stopped working properly, so I've just done 3 hours of that shift with no dishwasher. That was a hard shift. I just got the night off. Just spent the last 2 hours watching Netflix comedy specials with my mum. It was a good time though. It was nice to hear her laughing that much. It was nice to laugh that much as well myself, to be fair. I think I might go play Minecraft. Let's just say that the fact I'm awake right now is really, really lucky. Because a very strange thing happened to me this morning. I woke up sort of naturally. Which is strange, because I woke up after every alarm on my phone should have gone off, but they didn't. I picked up my phone, looked at it, I had notifications, yeah, you know, they'd all come through. Unlocked my phone, and then all of a sudden, every single notification since I went to sleep just came through, like, noises and my alarms came through. I was like, what the bloody hell's going on? I really hope that everything's working at work today, because I don't want another shift like yesterday. Well, dishwasher is working again. Instead, what I've got to deal with are very busy shifts. So I'm back tonight in a couple of hours, and then After that, there's only one shift left.
So whilst I was at work this lunchtime, I was thinking about next week's a week ago. You know, because obviously it's the end of a week ago, you know. There's a couple of people who sort of misinterpreted that as I'm stopping YouTube. I'm not stopping YouTube. Why the hell would I stop YouTube? You know, YouTube has given me quite a lot over the last 10 years. And, you know, at 1,700 subscribers, you know, I've hardly reached my peak, have I? At least I'd like to think so. You know, it was a year ago that I released a video which has done the best that my channel's ever done. And I haven't really come close to that since. But, you know, that's just YouTube, really. I'm putting some things in place to make sure that there is stuff worth watching for the finale. But I'm also going to try and keep it as reflective of my life as I can possibly keep it. Anyway, let's go to work for the penultimate time.
One shift to go. One minute you're just making tea in the kitchen, and then all of a sudden you're spinning around on a record player. So last night I started watching Better Call Saul. You know, I said I'd do it eventually. And last night just seemed like a good opportunity to do so. And I watched quite a lot of episodes last night. I watched 4 last night and I've watched 2 today. I'm not an episode by episode watcher, I'm a binge watcher. Unless it's on terrestrial TV, and then I like to watch it episode by episode. Anyway, you know what today is? Today is the day. My last shift at the tire works. It's gonna be emotional. It's not muffin time. Top Gun reference. It's work time. For the last time. In this context, at least. Yeah. Okay, let's go.
And that's the last shift at the tire works. Done. Yeah.
I just dropped the back of my earring and I can't find it. That's annoying. That's actually the second time I've lost the back of this earring. To this earring. The first time I lost it during a hug at a party, and I've lost it brushing my hair at home. It's race day, and Mark's prediction is not gonna happen.
Fingers crossed.
It's not gonna happen.
It may.
It's not gonna happen.
It may.
Yeah, if everyone bloody breaks down.
You're not gonna beat me.
It's lights out, and away we go. Leclerc gets away well. Hamilton and Bottas now jockeying for position.
Neither prediction was 100% correct, but I got more points. Yeah. It's been a very slow Sunday. You know, I didn't get out of bed until quite late because I was up quite late last night finishing season 1 of Better Call Saul, which, as far as I'm concerned, is pretty impressive because I only started watching it on Friday night / Saturday morning. Mum's currently downstairs cooking homemade spaghetti bolognese. It's going to be tagliatelle bolognese, so tagliatelle bolognese. Something about home cooked food that I just missed whilst I was living in my own place. Should be nice. I don't know why I'm saying it should be nice. I've been here a year now. I'm aware that it's nice. Now that was good pasta. And on that note, that has been another week. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you did do all that generic YouTube stuff, like, share, comment, subscribe, etc, etc. As always, I have been Ruby Price, and I shall see you a week ago. Adios. Bye.